Here's our 7-day outlook.
Welcome back. We're about 40 minutes past the hour. Welcome back to Weekend Recharge. And good morning, New York City. It's somewhere underneath the clouds and rain out there. Definitely a rainy, soggy beginning to your weekend. But hey, it is the final weekend of winter. That's good. No, it's rain, not snow. That's something to be happy about. We're looking for temperatures to warm up to the upper 40s today. And enjoy that, because as we head on towards, say, Wednesday, temperatures crash back down. Remind us that winter's not quite over yet. So don't let the kind of smooth temperatures fool you. It is getting cold again. So look at a forecast here, starting with Monday. 56 in the NYC. Our average is 49. We drop down to 37 for a high. That's it on Wednesday. And then we kind of bottom out, still below average as we head towards Thursday and Friday. Friday, the beginning of spring, and we're still about 6 degrees below average for that high. And then finally trying to get back to average as we head towards next weekend, right on time, the first weekend of spring. Let's talk about where this cold air is coming from. Anytime we have air and the jet stream moving across us, that's where the cold air is, north of the jet stream. So right now, we're going to be south of the jet stream, so milder air coming in, rain, hence snow. But once we head on towards the middle of this week, jet stream pushes south of us, cold air pummels the area from Canada once again, dropping our temperatures, yeah, to and even below freezing in many areas. Talking about some areas will have highs in the 20s this coming week. Let's take a look city by city. Monday, still quite comfortable. Everyone above average by just a couple to maybe even 10 degrees. Then Tuesday, about average for New York City, now below average in Boston. There we go, Buffalo, 6 degrees below average, a high of 36. As we head towards Wednesday, yeah, this should be the coldest, hopefully the last cold day of the winter season. 27 in Binghamton, 37 for a high in New York. Look at Boston, though. We're below freezing for a high, 30 degrees at 17 degrees below average. Burlington, Vermont, 24 degrees for a high on Wednesday. Even Pittsburgh, enjoy the weekend and Monday, because after that, we only stay in the 40s for highs through the rest of winter. Maria?
Paul, thank you. All right, each week I plan on sharing my passions in a segment called Momorology. The subjects will vary, but they're all going to be family friendly. They're going to have that science weather twist. And if you haven't heard, today is Pi Day. So I thought, what better way to get my kids and yours in on the fun while learning along the way? All right, you may think Pi Day is for math geeks, but actually it's a great opportunity, a learning opportunity, and a way to have fun with your family with math. And that's exactly what I want to do with my family today. So we're going to start with Tyler, who's 4. We have Justin, who's 6, and Michael, who's 9. And guys, pi is a mathematical representation of a number, and it's used to calculate things like circles. So we're going to start with this great craft that involves making circles, lots of circles. And it's great for little ones because it's crayon and paper. How easy is that? Okay, so what we've got is we drew a few starter circles, and what we're going to do is you guys grab a crayon.
I'm going to start off with pink.
And you're going to draw out many circles from the starter circles so that you end up with something like this, infinite circles. Another really fun project to do to help celebrate Pi Day would be to make jewelry and relate it to Pi. And in this case, we're going to make bracelets. So what we're going to do is just make a small bracelet. We're going to go out as far as we can with these numbers. So all I have is some stretchy string. Michael, you're going to do the numbers, right? So you're going to do the number beads. So the first number, of course, is 3. Now for my little guys, we're going to do something kind of fun. We're going to... Colors! We're going to use colors that correspond to certain numbers. So we follow the rainbow and we go 1 is red, orange is 2, 3 is yellow, and so on. So pick out a yellow bead.
And put it on.
And put it on.
Stop.
I'm wearing them right now.
I like that. Where's mine?
And your skiing forecast.
Weather in Play brought to you by Audi, proud sponsor of the U.S. Ski Team.
Grandpa Bodhi, Grandma said you used to be out of control.
Really? I guess I did take some risks. I trained a little bit differently. I was a little too honest sometimes.
The media is useless.
You were out of control.
But not always.
Let's do this. It's asleep. So let's wake it up with the most important meal of the year. Let's get the right recipe, the right ingredients, right in our budget. Then let's get out there and cook ourselves up a big old plate of spring. Let's do this. Kill weeds and bugs and get 25% off with Ortho or Roundup. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
Oh. That detergent was like half the price.
And we'll have to use like double, maybe more.
I'm going back to the store.
Yes, you are.
Dish issues? Get Cascade Complete. One pack cleans tough food better than six packs of the bargain brand combined. Cascade, now that's clean.
This March,
one man's trash.
Thank you. Now, can I at least put my shoes on?
If your bladder is calling the shots, you may have a medical condition called overactive bladder, or OAB.
You've got to be kidding me. I've had enough. It's time to talk to the doctor.
Ask your doctor how Mirbetric may help treat OAB symptoms of urgency, frequency, and leakage, which may mean fewer trips to the bathroom.
Mirbetric Mirabegron may increase your blood pressure. Mirbetric may increase your chances of not being able to empty your bladder. Tell your doctor right away if you have trouble emptying your bladder or have a weak urine stream. Mirbetric may affect or be affected by other medications, so tell your doctor about all the medicines you take. Before taking Mirbetric, tell your doctor if you have liver or kidney problems. Common side effects include increased blood pressure, common cold symptoms, urinary tract infection, and headache.
Take charge by talking to your doctor about your OAB symptoms and Mirbetric. Find out if you can get your first prescription at no cost by visiting Mirbetric.com.
800-805-4176. Online at drstumpgrinder.com.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies with windy conditions. Today, a mix of clouds and sun. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 85. Tonight, a few passing clouds. Low 70. Winds south-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 87. Chance of rain 40%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
It's beginning to look a lot like St. Patrick's Day. Yeah, check out the Chicago River here in Chicago. It's their annual tradition of dyeing that river green, and crews just began to do it. In fact, St. Patrick's Day, by the way, is this Tuesday, and the forecast here in the shy, mostly sunny skies, and highs moving into the 40s. And here's a little fun fact for you. The color of the dye they use to turn that river green is actually orange. Maria?
That blows my mind. I don't know why. It just, science is awesome. Science is awesome. You've got blue water, orange dye, you got a green river now. It's just amazing. All right, time now to get you updated on some of the winter weather that we're tracking. And there you got Chicago right there off of Lake Michigan. But this is a look at how the Great Lakes look yesterday. And you can see the ones that are ice covered by a lot and then ones that are more open. So you have Lake Michigan's pretty open, Lake Ontario's pretty open, but you've got Lake Erie, Lake Huron, and Lake Superior that are really ice covered. So still that time of year, even though overall the total ice coverage has come down a bit. Let's take you to Lake Superior, beautiful Bayfield, Wisconsin. Oh, look, you've got a little car there, I think, on the ice. It's been that way for a while on Lake Superior. You're probably ready for spring. Let's see if we can get you that. It's going to be a little bit more to go here, this last official full weekend of winter here, and we've got it certainly in the Northeast. So let's start there. In the areas in purple, the freezing rain advisories, portions of the Hudson River Valley off to the west, western of Massachusetts, some lingering moisture there, cold enough temperatures, you may get a little bit of glazing. But it's further to the north, those areas in blues, those winter storm watches, the advisories, and the warnings here for additional snowfall, especially as we get through later in the day. Look at the situation right now. You've got plenty of moisture, but you've got a lot of green on the screen. So that's rain, cold rain, Scranton at 38, cold rain in New York at 45, and it's still rain in Boston, but you're right on the edge at 34 degrees. So we're going to get any help with the cold air? Yeah, we're going to see the jet stream give us another dose here. You've got plenty of moisture, that being supplied off to the south, so you get that coming together right over into the northeast, and you got yourself some additional snowfall. So as we get into the weekend, that storm develops inland. What that's going to do is not only bring down the colder air, but it's also going to wind up those winds. It's going to be gusty. It's going to be raw as we go through the next few days, so watch out for that. As we get through tonight, though, you still see the I-95 corridor, say between D.C., Philadelphia, New York, Hartford, on up into Providence and Boston. You've got the rain so far. And then by tonight and through tomorrow, that colder air continues to pour on down, and now it's a little bit sketchier here from Boston into, say, Springfield and Hartford. Snow possible here, but the winner of the snowfall total will definitely be northern New England, more specifically interior Maine here. We're looking at a whopping 8 to 12 inches likely, places like Bangor. But you've got Portland in that 3, maybe 3 to 5 inch range, and Boston, 2 more inches to break the season record. We're forecasting 1, so we'll keep an eye on it. Weekend Recharge returns in a few minutes.
Americans, 83% try to eat healthy, yet up to 90% fall short in getting key nutrients from food alone. Let's do more. Add one-a-day women's gummies, complete with key nutrients we may need, plus it supports bone health with calcium and vitamin D. One-a-day VitaCraves gummies.
Is your back acting up again? Is lower back pain a daily drain? If you're one of the millions who suffer from the agony of lower back pain, you need Be Active, the revolutionary new pressure system that helps ease discomfort in your lower back, buttocks, and legs. Watch. Just slip on Be Active and tighten the strap. You'll soon begin experiencing pain relief. Look, back pain often radiates from the lower back to your lower extremities. But apply Be Active to the point in the calf muscle to relieve pain. The secret is the pressure pad that gently compresses, alleviating pain to the nerve and lower back.
Be Active provides firm pressure behind the knee on a specific pressure point, which can help relieve the pain and suffering from sciatica.
I just slide it on, I tighten the strap, I feel the pressure point right behind my knee, and right away I feel the release of pain in my lower back.
Wow, I can feel comfort already.
It's like right away relief.
I just put it on, but I can feel it already easing the pain.
You can't see the relief? I can feel it.
It kind of feels like it's relaxing, that muscle.
But now I don't feel the pain at all. This is really something.
Be Active gives you the ability to be active again. Wear it while exercising. Keep up with the kids. It's invisible under clothing, comfortable enough to sleep in. Be Active easily adjusts to fit almost any leg. Be Active is always there to deliver the pain relief you need. Now feel the freedom of being active again with the pressure point therapy of Be Active for just $19.99. But wait, call now and we'll double the offer free. Just pay separate processing. If you don't begin to feel quick back relief, send it back and owe nothing. You get it all for just $19.99. So call or click now.
To order, call 1-800-732-6143. That's 1-800-732-6143. Or go online at beactivebrace.com. Call or click today. That's 1-800-732-6143.
Mother Nature can absolutely change people.
I'm ready to get out of here and create a new track.
This is a tornado emergency.
Oh, it was hard to believe weather could do that.
Never seen anything like this in my life.
Seven years ago, a deadly tornado tracked through downtown Atlanta. Remember that?
I do.
Yeah.
Yeah, in fact, there was the SEC championship going on, and that was an EF2 twister that actually killed one person, injured 30 others, and it passed pretty close to the Georgia Dome where the game was going on. But here's the thing, it went to overtime, and I think that really helped save a lot more people from injuries, maybe even death, because people were in there inside, still watching the game as this thing went by.
Yeah, and just by the numbers, the tornado caused $25 million in damages.
Yeah, and people think, oh, no, you can't have tornadoes in urban areas.
Yeah, you can.
We can.
It's one of those wonderments of weather, right? And so we love to end the hour kind of on that note where you kind of just take it in. It's amazing out there. And we have some great pictures to share with you. This one I love, Catherine's put, cruising altitude. We're not sure how high up, but it's a beautiful overview somewhere between Birmingham and Charlotte.
Yeah, Catherine also emailed that now Delta Airlines is encouraging people to take flights as, or take pictures as they take their flights to kind of document what's going on here. But back here on the ground, take a look at this. Yeah, Jim Cantore took these pictures in the cold morning after some fog and ice fog. I would call it perhaps a frozen fog in the area.
And, you know, there's nothing like a good classic cloud. But take note, too, this is using the Weather Channel app. It allows you to put the conditions on and take that picture. It is amazing out there, and we appreciate you sending that in to us.
Out of Massachusetts.
And always love a good, good sunrise picture. And this time of year, you still get those beautiful colors, right? Good morning, river runners. Running the river there in Florida, Jacksonville.
Yeah, fantastic view there. And I think spring breakers, they might go to bed seeing the sunset.
It's a different view for them.
That's
a bedtime sunrise, yeah. But we hope you have a great hour. Stick around. Weekend Recharge is gearing up for another hour as we leave you with this stunning picture of the Grand Canyon.
That's right, because our show is like that. It is out of this world.
Wow.
Shelley? How'd you come to find the biggest liquid gold mine in the state?
I was shopping for provisions.
Yeah?
And that's when I saw it.
What'd you see, Shelly?
Boxes and boxes of Belvedere shells and cheese got clear to the ceiling.
Can we go look at it, Shelly?
Yeah, right over here.
Oh!
There's gold in them there shells. Liquid gold.
What's he doing? You think I have time to run into?
Golfsmith. Anything for golf. Need new tires? Right now at Pep Boys, when you buy three Falcon, Cooper, or Hankook tires, you get the fourth tire free instantly. Plus, get special financing for 12 months on purchases of $4.99 or more on your Pep Boys credit card. Trust the boys to get you there.
Sweet mother of softness, Charmin.
Take a closer look at Charmin Ultra Soft and you'll love what you see. Not only can you use less, but you can actually see the softness in our comfort cushions.
We all go. Why not enjoy the go with Charmin Ultra Soft?
For 4 days only at Men's Warehouse, great savings just got even better. Right now, buy one, get one free on almost everything in the store. Plus, take an additional 30% off all clearance items, from suits to dress shirts and more. Confidence in every look. Only at Men's Warehouse.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees, under partly cloudy skies with windy conditions. Today, a mix of clouds and sun. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 85. Tonight, a few passing clouds. Low 70. Winds south-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 87. Chance of rain 40%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
A good Saturday morning to you, and welcome to the debut of Weekend Recharge. I'm Paul Goodloe.
And I'm Maria LaRosa. For the next 2 hours, we want you to unplug, get lost in the weather, kind of put things aside so you can focus, take it all in, and enjoy yourself. Watch with the family.
Yeah, take the phone. Mm-hmm. There it is. You're going to, you know, that's right. The big circle with line. We're going to kind of push him off. There you go.
Oh, that way.
That way. Move along here. So unplug, no email, no text messages, no cell phones, no. This is the morning you want you to get caught up what's going on out there mm-hmm. and get you prepared for what's to come next week. In fact, right now, the big concern is all the rain and the flooding because the fear is rising as well as floodwaters here. A double whammy of unseasonably warm temperatures, even heavy rain, now triggering everything from floods to ice jams, even landslides from the south to the Midwest, even the Northeast.
Plus, you are looking at the most powerful storm on the planet right now. Cyclone Pam packing deadly and destructive winds of 155 miles per hour in the South Pacific Islands. It is the equivalent of a Category 5 hurricane.
3 weeks ago, it was freezing, and I would have to wear like 5 layers outside, but now it's gorgeous.
Yeah, forget about spring. Some of you are leaping over that season and getting right into summer on this final weekend of winter. See where records will be melting faster than ice cream cones.
Ice cream. But we want to give you the snapshot as you recharge from the week that was and you're getting recharged for the week ahead. A big picture of all the stories that we're going to show you today, get you ready for the next week. And a big part of it is this big area across the west, the record heat dominated by the high pressure. We'll talk about all of the records that are going to fall. And yes, winter's last stand. Can you believe it's the last full weekend of winter and it's hanging on by a thread? So we'll talk about that. And then the last day of rain from the Ohio Valley into the Mid-Atlantic and the Southeast, which is actually really good news, a little bit of a relief because so many waterways, the rivers and the creeks in that area are busting their banks and they don't need that additional rainfall right
now. And speaking of rain and flood concerns, it's a huge concern across the Vermilion River in Ohio. An ice jam broke, causing the river to overflow.
Yeah, we had the water seeping into nearby roadways, the homes. WKYC's Alyssa Raymond is along the riverbanks with more.
Residents here in Vermilion on Riverside Drive are expecting this other ice jam to break later this afternoon. The first jam happened around 3:30. It gave way in Mill Hollow, causing the water from the Vermilion River to come and jam in this area. Residents weren't mandatory. There was not a mandatory evacuation in this area, but some of the people chose to stay here. Others decided to leave. We've had cars come up to where the water is coming in and they decided to turn around and not venture down that way. We have river water flowing 20, 30 miles per hour further up the river. This river in this area is usually 75 feet across, but you can see that it extends way in a much wider range than it usually is. There's a flash flood warning in effect for both eastern Erie County as well as western Lorain County. Reporting in Vermilion, Alyssa Raymond, WKYC News.
Right now, 17 states are under some kind of flood alert right now. Taking a look at three cities dealing with a threat of flooding. Indianapolis on the upper left, upper right, Cleveland, and even Philly. Some rain coming in right now. You're seeing some rain for much of your soggy Saturday. In fact, take a look at this. Flood watches stretch across the Ohio River Valley into areas of the eastern Great Lakes, including Cleveland and even Erie and Buffalo, New York right now. And a closer look at the Ohio coastline of Lake Erie here, still dealing with flood concerns and death. Ashtabula and to even Toledo concerned with that ice now breaking up on some rivers causing some concerns. Vermilion River, we thought it crested on Thursday morning. It did, the first crest at least. Now it was moving down, but with that ice jam breaking, that river now gauge is showing more and more flooding across the area back into the moderate flood stage. And here's a picture of this along the shore here of all the ice being broken up. And once that ice breaks, the river, which has kind of been dammed up behind it, starts to rush downstream and over its banks and, yeah, causing more damage like this and more flooding into people's homes. Yeah, not what you want to deal with as you're hoping for the end of all this winter weather. Again, last weekend of winter. Scattered rain showers here, more like drizzle right now, but the rain is the least of our concerns. It's the melting going on as warm air comes across the region. But again, warm enough air, so Really, we're talking about wet weather, not snowy weather across the region, except as you head towards New England as we head through this weekend. Snow is in your forecast. Scattered showers here, and still can't rule out a couple of thunderstorms, especially later on this afternoon. But with the cold air on the backside of the system coming through, even the mountains of West Virginia, Western Maryland, and Western PA could see a little snow-rain mixture as well. But not a whole lot of heavy rain, about a half inch to about an inch. The heaviest will be with some of those thunderstorms, because our moisture source is the Gulf of Mexico, and it continues to bring this warm moist flow across the region, and it continues through tonight. But as this cold front pushes on through, we'll start slowly kind of clearing out areas of the southeast as we head to your Sunday. So look for definitely some drier weather as we head towards Sunday, and some warmer weather as well. But definitely in the northeast New England, on the backside of the system, could even see more snow in places like Boston, Maria, where 2 inches from breaking our records might even get close or closer to that as we head through this weekend.
Okay. All right. Out west, it's definitely not winter. It's feeling a lot more like summer, more than 20 degrees above average in Southern California. Records broken in L.A., Long Beach, and Santa Barbara, just to name a few. And more will be broken today with temperatures into the low 90s.
It took James Dyson 5,000 prototypes to invent the bagless vacuum, and another 10,000 to invent the only vacuum that doesn't lose suction, thanks to patented sonic tips. Everything else is history. Search Kinetic now.
I love my Meta Health Bars, because when nutritious tastes this delicious, I don't miss the other stuff.
Meta Health Bars help promote heart health. Experience the Meta effect with our multi-health wellness line.
I Sverige är vi kända för att köra världens säkraste bilar. Som ibland innebär ett svårt val. Som att köra en bil tillverkad i Amerika? No.
Introducing the new all-wheel drive Chrysler 200. America's import. Find it at Chrysler.com.
Boston Market introduces our 2-for-20 complete meal deal. For just $20, get two individual meals, like our all-natural rotisserie chicken, two classic sides, two drinks, and two desserts, all for a limited time, only at Boston Market.
Sometimes, bigger is better. But other times, bigger just gets in the way. At Brother, we know the biggest printer isn't always the best fit for every office. So we've come up with a bigger idea. Don't supersize, optimize. See how we can help you put the right printers in all the right places and help reduce your costs. Now that's big. Brother, at your side. Learn more at don'tsupersizeoptimize.com.
If you're taking multiple medications, does your mouth often feel dry? A dry mouth can be a side effect of many medications, but it can also lead to tooth decay and bad breath. That's why there's Biotene, available as an oral rinse, toothpaste, spray, or gel. Biotene can provide soothing relief, and it helps keep your mouth healthy, too. Remember, while your medication is doing you good, a dry mouth isn't. Biotene, for people who suffer from a dry mouth.
Pain from your day can haunt you at night. Don't let it. Advil PM gives you the healing sleep you need, helping you fall asleep and stay asleep so your body can heal as you rest. Advil PM, for a healing night's sleep.
I have a cold with terrible chest congestion. I better take something.
Theraflu Severe Cold doesn't treat chest congestion.
Really?
New Alka-Seltzer Plus Day Powder rushes relief to your worst cold symptoms plus chest congestion.
Oh, what a relief it is.
For 4 days only at Men's Warehouse, great savings just got even better. Right now, buy one, get one free on almost everything in the store. Plus, take an additional 30% off all clearance items, from suits to dress shirts and more. Confidence in every look. Only at Men's Warehouse.
At last.
Sometimes at last doesn't happen at first.
My love has come along.
Turning two worlds into one takes love.
And life is like a song.
Helping protect that world takes State Farm.
Tomorrow night, extreme weather of biblical proportions.
The gates of hell are opening up, and this is the entry to it.
Top 10 Bible weather, tomorrow night at 9 on the Weather Channel.
today. A mix of clouds and sun. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 83. Winds southeast at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Tonight, mainly clear, low 70. Winds south-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, thunderstorms develop. Here's our 7-day outlook.
I've never been so terrified.
When you go out there, it's dangerous.
Welcome back to the debut of our new show, Weekend Recharge.
Yes, and this is the final weekend of winter, but out west, it does not look or feel anything like that, especially across Southern California and the Southwest. L.A., or technically Santa Monica there on the upper left side of your picture, the pier. And then on the right, upper right, you got Phoenix, otherwise known as Phoenix, Arizona, where, yeah, you're also pushing into the 90-degree mark. And meanwhile, you have Las Vegas, or Las Vegas, as some call it, where they actually had a record high low, which means the morning low temperature had never been that warm.
That is crazy. Now, the heat, definitely a problem for runners in the LA Marathon tomorrow. We're talking near record highs expected. Race officials are urging participants to just slow it down.
KNBC's Michelle Vowles takes a look at what they're doing to help people prepare for the heat.
On your mark, get set, sweat. Record-breaking numbers expected for the 30th annual LA Marathon and forecast.
Oh, I'm actually from London, so they're really record for me. I mean, this is winter, it's great.
Unless you're a runner, 26,000 will attempt 26.2 miles. Now tack on an additional dangerous challenge, the grueling heat. A high of 89 Sunday in Santa Monica at the finish line. With the heat posing a high risk to runners and volunteers, organizers moved up the marathon 30 minutes to 6:55, where it'll be 64 degrees with 40% humidity on Sunday out at Dodger Stadium. They're also asking runners to slow it down.
We really just want to encourage runners to kind of dial it back and come out and really just enjoy the event, but also to take personal responsibility.
Medical tents will be set up every 2 miles in case runners feel dizzy or faint. Cooling buses, misting stations, cold towels and ice, and plenty of liquids along the route to beat the heat.
Starting at mile 2, we will have water and Gatorade endurance formula on both sides of the street, and that will be placed every mile.
The heat is on this weekend for those running or not.
Hydration. Yeah. Stay hydrated.
Stay covered. Sunscreen, hats, you know, you can't beat it. Love it.
You know, I was going to run that marathon, but then I remembered, oh, yeah, I don't run marathons. But, hey, if you are, it is going to be hot there. We're pushing towards a record even today in L.A. And look at this, Sunday for the forecast, we start in the 60s. When you start that warm, close to 70, you know it's going to be a hot day. Because, by the way, that should be your high for the day. The average high this time of the year is 68. We're pushing back towards 90 degrees throughout the heat of the afternoon. It's all thanks to a big ridge of high pressure and the offshore flow. That's the air coming from the interior going down the mountains and heats up as it sinks. And that is setting us up for some record-setting temperatures again all across and only Southern California, parts of Southern Nevada, even Arizona, Phoenix. You know it's hot when people in Phoenix say, hey, it's kind of hot today. We're pushing towards 90. We should be around 76. This is the ideal time to be in Phoenix. We're pushing towards 90. Even LA, that could be a record, another record today, 93. Should be in the upper 60s. Look at this. Highs today, Sacramento, even Sacramento, above average. Should be in the upper 60s as well. We're in the lower 80s. There's at 93 in Long Beach. San Diego, staying classy and steamy, 87 for a record high today. Maria?
All right, I'm going to see those heat stats of yours, and I'm going to raise you because places like Rapid City, South Dakota, I mean, you're sitting at 42 degrees, not bad, but you're headed all the way up to 74, and we're going to see records breaking all over the place. That's nearly 30 degrees above average, by the way. On top of that, Rapid City, red flag warning in effect starting at noon, so you've got the gusty winds, the low humidity, and that's prompting that warning for you. So a couple of things to watch out for here in this neck of the woods, but it's definitely the heat record setting well into the weekend. This stat is pretty amazing. We're going to use Bismarck as an example of what's happening here. You have a record high Sunday that was 68 degrees set in 1995. Are you looking at the forecast? 78 will set the record for the warmest so early in the season and the record high for the date. This is a lot, and this is extreme. So the setup here is perfect for it. We have the jet stream way to the north, so we're not getting any intrusion of cold air. High pressure's building in. That's warm. It's dry, and that allows the air to heat up that much faster and more efficiently. You've got 20 to 35 degrees above average here from Minneapolis, Bismarck, down to, say, Wichita. Even for today, Chicago, St. Louis, 10 to 14 degrees above the average. That's mid and upper 50s, lower 60s. And then tomorrow, to wrap up the weekend, you've got North Platte sitting at 82 degrees. But take a look at this. Highs dropping tomorrow, likely Bismarck, Fargo, Aberdeen, Rapid City. But take a look at this. Paul, the lows forecast on Monday from Minneapolis to Fargo, more in line with the average highs. They're going to be into the 40s.
As the kids say, that is cray-cray. Hey, will it cool down? We'll find out coming up in your seven-day forecast. We call it the seven-day stretch. And take a look at Breckenridge. Beautiful snow here, more than 20 feet. Great for spring skiing.
Let me talk to you about retirement.
A 401k is the most sound way to go. Let's talk asset allocation.
Sure.
You seem knowledgeable, professional.
I'm actually a DJ.
No way.
That really is you.
If they're not a CFP pro, you just don't know. CFP, work with the highest standard.
I want my yoga pants to smell like I sweat money.
I want to smell the way champagne tastes. I love champagne.
Infuse your laundry with up to 12 weeks of luxurious, long-lasting scents. Unstoppables In-Wash Scent Booster.
Can a protein originally found in a jellyfish improve your memory? Our scientists say yes. Researchers have discovered a protein that actually supports healthier brain function. It's the breakthrough in a supplement called Prevagen. As we age, we lose proteins that support our brain. Prevagen supplements these proteins and has been clinically shown to improve memory. It's safe and effective. For support of healthier brain function, a sharper mind, and clearer thinking, try Prevagen for yourself today.
My job is so hard on my hands.
The cracks were the worst part.
O'Keefe's Working Hands. Guaranteed relief for dry hands that crack and split.
There was a difference within just minutes of it absorbing into my skin.
Only O'Keefe's has given me the relief that I need.
Learn more at workinghands.com.
What's this?
A box. It takes worn out things and makes them better. Want to see?
Yeah.
Cool. What else you got?
It's our biggest breakthrough yet. We're taking worn-out batteries and making them into something strong. New Energizer Eco Advanced, world's first long-lasting battery made with 4% recycled batteries.
You know those neighbors always making weird inventions out of junk in their garage? We just gave them their own TV show.
Come on, Wind.
I think I just made Mother Nature my bitch.
One man's trash?
This is...
Hi, I'm Jeannie Francis, and like many of you, I've struggled with my weight and made a lot of great excuses, but no more. I tried Nutrisystem, and I lost 10 pounds, then 20, then 30, and I realized I can do this.
Lose weight fast with Nutrisystem's Fast 5 Plus Kit. Lose 5 pounds in your first week, plus 1 inch off your waist or your money back, guaranteed.
I'm Jeannie Francis, and I lost 30 pounds with Nutrisystem. Nutrisystem is so simple. I don't have to count or measure, and the food is really good.
Order your 28-day Nutrisystem plan right now, including Fast 5 Plus. Get 1 week of specially selected meals, plus 1 week of energizing shakes free, and 1 week of Craving Crusher shakes free.
Take the drama out of losing weight. You can do this. Call or click right now.
Call 877-699-SIZE right now and get Fast 5 Plus with shakes free.
And even pay the return postage. Try NoNo risk-free today.
tomorrow night. Extreme weather of biblical proportions.
The gates of hell are opening up, and this is the entry to it.
Top 10 Bible weather, tomorrow night at 9 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 82 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, a mix of clouds and sun. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 83. Tonight, mainly clear, low 70. Winds south-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 87. Chance of rain 40%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
I think the best use of a selfie stick to date. Don't you think?
I do.
Yeah.
That takes skill.
That does take skill. And he's perfectly centered in the shot. This is a skier on Breckenridge Mountain in Colorado, decided to capture a beautiful day on the slopes.
I think it's one of the instructors too. They got some great instructors. They showed me and a couple other people there for a conference around on January. We had a fantastic time. They have, I believe, the highest lift, chairlift, in the lower 48.
As in altitude?
It goes up to like 12, almost 13,000 feet.
Oh my gosh, wow. Oof.
But that high, you definitely need a sunscreen, even at the peak of the bottom of base 8, peak 8 still. Talking about sunshine, and we're warming up here. Temperatures pushing to the 50s, but still, they got over 20 feet of snow, so.
They're good.
They could use a little melting and still have plenty more for the skiers and boarders.
Ah, sounds great. All right, let's get you thinking about this weekend and the next 7 days. We're calling it the 7-day stretch.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of days to get through, so we're going to start with today and think about your plans. As the soccer game's canceled, I'm thinking, in parts of the east.
Yeah, because of the field soggy, because we've seen rain in some areas since yesterday. Continue overnight, so plenty of wet weather across the area. And look at this. So last weekend of winter, we're still holding on to wintry weather. But hey, skiers and snowboarders here are loving this, a powder morning.
And we're going to kind of see this a lot the next few days. Some green in the Pacific Northwest, rain along the 5, Seattle 70, should say 56 degrees.
But again, this wintry weather hangs on for Sunday as well. Let's check in with our affiliate, NECN.
Hi, I'm meteorologist Matt Noyes from NECN. This weekend, we're paying special attention here to New England and Boston. We have rain that may start out as a little freezing rain on Saturday morning, but by the time we get to Sunday, mountain snow in New England, the cold air comes south. We should flip to snow. Even in Boston for the big St. Patrick's Day parade in South Boston, it'll be snowing. That's pretty apropos given the way this season has gone. Back to you.
Matt, thank you.
Yeah, and there's that snow he's talking about across New England. Temperatures cooling down as well, but nice in Atlanta. Sun returns 73.
And you see the lack of weather here in the midsection. You've got the high pressure building in. Records highs will be dropping. We're talking from Rapid City. Minneapolis at 68. Chicago, 61 degrees, well above average.
Good travel day for people.
Great
on your Sunday.
Day.
Monday as well. The middle of the nation is pretty quiet as well. In the Northeast, snow is out, rain is out, except northern parts of Maine. Temperatures, though, will peak on Monday before they start to cool down.
All right, so Monday we find ourselves in the northern tier with a little bit of snow. Nothing major. Still baking, though, in the southwest. You've got Phoenix once again approaching 90 degrees above average.
As we head towards Tuesday, seeing the rain creep into areas of Texas and now the interior of the Northeast, they go the temperatures, and here come, yes, more wintry type precip across regions of snow. A little mixture here across areas of southern New England as well.
And you have some rain in the inland Pacific Northwest. We're going to keep an eye on this. Dallas, you're at 72 on Tuesday with the rain showers. Let's take you live there right now. You have the gray skies, 59 degrees, and I'm thinking you're thinking it's feeling a little hazy too, a little muggy. You've got the moisture coming back, and it's kind of planted itself there even as we get into Wednesday. You can see there.
And that wet weather not only confined to Texas on Wednesday, pushing across the Gulf Coast state. So Atlanta, you start cooling down on your Wednesday, but by Thursday, well, you got rain into the area and temperatures now actually where they should be this time of the year, talking about 50s for highs.
And it's the last official full 24 hours of winter. You still have some showers hanging on in the Pacific Northwest, not much in the way of snow in the Rockies. It is all about the rain in the south and the southeast for now.
And across the Northeast, it's all about the cold temperatures. Winter's still holding on, a high of only 36 here in Boston. But hey, D.C., well, take a look at this. Friday, the first day of spring, and when will this happen? Yeah, the cherry blossoms is also the kickoff of a spring favorite, the National Cherry Blossom Festival in our nation's capital. It built itself as the nation's greatest springtime celebration. The historic Tidal Basin is ringed by Yoshino cherry trees, a gift from our friends in Japan. Here's some facts on it. Going on in D.C. from March 20th through April 12th. Now, the Park Service, they predict when the peak of the blooms will be, so you can plan your trips. The peak forecasted to be April 11th to 14th, just after Easter. And by the way, Maria, the average peak is March 30th. So now this is delayed because of this brutal winter we had.
It's been so cold. And basically west of the Mississippi, you are dry. Not so much along the Ohio River Valley this morning. It's expected to crest in Cincinnati tomorrow. Highest level since the flood of 97. Up next, where rain and ice are raising even more concern about flooding.
Weather in Play, brought to you by Audi, proud sponsor of the U.S. Ski Team.
Grandpa Bodie, Grandma said you used to be out of control.
Really? I guess I did take some risks. I trained a little bit differently. I was a little too honest sometimes.
The media is useless.
You were out of control.
But not always.
First.
No, you're not. You went first last time.
Why are those lines on my floor?
A distance contest.
I already made it from this line.
For life's bleachable moments.
To stay one step ahead of winter, it takes the latest state-of-the-art technology. The ultimate protection for any car, truck, or SUV is WeatherTech Floor Liners. They're laser measured to perfectly protect your vehicle, front, back, even up the sides. Simply go to WeatherTech.com and order your ultimate vehicle protection today. Or call 1-800-CAR-MATS. This winter calls for WeatherTech.
Whatever their stickers say, they'll all lose suction because their filters clog. But with our sonic tips oscillating at 5,000 hertz, only new Dyson Kinetic Science won't lose suction.
Claritin D presents two allergy sufferers. One had allergies with nasal congestion, so he tried the newest allergy spray, which could take several days to feel the full effect of relief. The other went straight to the pharmacy counter for the fast, powerful relief of Claritin D. It's tough on allergies with nasal congestion and starts to work in just 30 minutes. The moral? Nothing works faster than Claritin D. Find it at the pharmacy counter and live Claritin Clear.
According to the U.S. Department of Energy, most homes have air leaks and drafts that waste so much energy, it's like leaving a window open in your home all year long. Don't let another year go by. Call Champion Windows at 844-4-CHAMPION. And right now, when you buy two rooms of windows, you get the third room free. Plus, Champion now offers no money down, no payments, and no interest for 12 months. So call 844-4-CHAMPION today. Because every home needs a champion.
You know those neighbors always making weird inventions out of junk in their garage? We just gave them their own TV show.
I think I just made Mother Nature my bitch.
One man's trash.
This is perfect.
Is another man's wood-powered Jeep gasifier.
Brainstormers, premiering Sunday, March 22nd, only on the Weather Channel.
Today, a mix of clouds and sun. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 83. Winds southeast at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Tonight, mainly clear. Low 70. Winds south-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 87. Chance of rain 40%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
tomorrow night. Extreme weather of biblical proportions.
The gates of hell are opening up, and this is the entry to it.
Top 10 Bible weather tomorrow night at 9 on the Weather Channel.
It is 30 past the hour, and you are watching Weekend Recharge. So glad that you can join us. I'm Marie LaRosa.
And I'm Paul Goodloe. So glad you can spend your last weekend of winter with us. Not that we're counting, but there's actually six more days
until we're totally
spring.
Counting.
Yeah, we're counting big time. And by the look of a lot of front pages today, a lot of people are definitely ready for a change in the seasons. Check this one out.
Yeah, part of our show, we're going to kind of get you local here and talk about what local areas are covering as far as weather. So the front page of the Los Angeles Daily News, the big story is spring early. Bloomers. You know, it's been warm, it's been dry, so it's kind of driving some of those early pups.
Yeah, warm and dry is what they wish they had across parts of Grand Rapids. And check out the front page of the Press here. And it says, yeah, flooding the huge concern there. The threat is out there as temperatures are rising, snow is melting, and rivers are being flooded. And ice dams breaking also increase that risk as we have winter starting to thaw across this region.
And one more, check out the front page of the Press out of Atlantic City, New Jersey. The blessing of negative 6 degrees. The article talks about how the extreme cold in January and February will actually help in the battle against southern pine beetle, which is known for destroying trees, which I think is a great segment we should probably do on our show to talk about the bugs. And, you know, you have the temperature impacting there, but things like the floodwaters, it's driving bugs out of the ground,
It's all connected.
Yeah.
Weather is basically everything we do. That's what we talk about it here on Weekend Recharge
and
the Weather Channel. Hey, speaking of the warmer weather, the warmer temperatures are now causing amazing pictures like this one out of Cleveland, Ohio. These are huge chunks of ice making their way down the Vermilion River.
Whew, look at that. The ice jam is causing flooding, but there are no mandatory evacuations in the area right now. It will be cloudy this weekend and highs up into the 40s.
And a mess here in Ohio this morning, an ice jam on that very river, the Vermilion River, broke. And in fact, it was causing major flooding, something people living near the banks feared would happen.
I'm terrified. Yeah, I am pretty scared. I've been moving all of my stuff upstairs for the last couple days.
They were for a time under that flash flood warning. More ice is expected to break this afternoon. Residents are taking extreme caution to stay safe in the floodwaters, Paul.
That's right. In fact, a threat for flooding on these three cities also continues today. You got Cleveland, little low clouds out there. You got Pittsburgh, rain continues to move on through in Rehoboth Beach. Well, yeah, I hope you're out early because now the rain continues to get closer and closer. It's going to be a soggy Saturday for you. In fact, we're going to see a soggy Saturday for many across the eastern third of the nation. And right now we are concerned with flooding. Flood watches up across the Ohio River Valley into areas of West Virginia, in western PA, even western New York dealing with it as well. And take a look at the gauge here of the Ohio River, which is at Cincinnati, this location. We were in action stage here ever since the end of this week. Now, again, we're forecasting a crest sometime tomorrow morning before we slowly start receding it. But the big question is, do we have more rain? Do we have this warmer air coming in, help more melting and more flooding into the rivers? So we'll keep a close eye on that as we head through this coming week. But on the radar, maybe a few more light rain showers heading on towards Cincinnati. This is not the type of rain which will cause flood concerns to go up at all. It's just more nuisance and a reminder that, yeah, we could see heavier rain cause a lot of bigger problems, but that's not going to be the story, at least today, across the Ohio Valley. Southeast, showers, even a few thunderstorms, not now, but later on this afternoon, as we have the heating of a very strong March sun out there. You definitely could see a slight risk of some strong, maybe even some borderline severe thunderstorms. But trust me, we'll have stronger days to come. But overall, scattered rain showers continue to start to taper off as we head on towards tonight. And with the cold air coming in the backside of the system, some of the higher elevations of West Virginia, Western Maryland, even Western PA could see a little snow mix in there as well. Better chance of snow across New England. More on that coming up. But in terms of the heaviest rainfall is where we could see some thunderstorms erupt here across North Carolina. Maybe a half inch to an inch of rain. So the forecast continues to bring this moisture up from the Gulf of Mexico. But look at the southern branch of our jet stream. That's why we're warming up so much. Again, it's helping to bring this moisture and the warmer air across a good chunk of the eastern half of the nation. Meanwhile, the colder jet stream is just going to clip parts of New England and a bigger push of that cold air on Sunday, then into next week as well. But as the cold front comes through, this will act like a squeegee and finally kind of clear our atmosphere as we head towards Sunday. So even if you're Saturday is soggy. Sunday is looking a lot drier as well. But our forecast right here, eastern central North Carolina, throughout the early afternoon hours, we could see some thunderstorms erupt. And then by sundown, the threat for severe weather diminishes and the rain starts to slowly taper off as we head throughout tonight as well. Maria?
All right, Paul, thank you. We are also tracking a powerful South Pacific cyclone that has come ashore on the chain of islands that make up Vanuatu. Damage from Cyclone Pam is widespread throughout the capital city of Port Vila. No word yet on injuries or deaths. Power is out in many places, and unfortunately, we continue to see those pictures come into the news center here, and the damage is widespread. Looking at this this image, you have the wind streams, and this is courtesy of earth.nullschool.net, and your eyes immediately go right here. That is the circulation around Pam. It is still very intense, but not the only one that we're tracking on this map. The Pacific Basin is really active right now. You have Bobby, you have Nathan, you have Olwen. So let's go across the equator where we have our cyclones rotating the other way. Circulation goes counterclockwise. You've got right now max winds at 60 miles per hour. It's moving to the west at 16. You do have an island chain there. But not a major threat at this point. Still a powerful cyclone, Pam, right now. Max winds at 150 miles per hour. It is screeching to the south-southeast at 29 miles per hour. So on that track and that forecast, we have it by tomorrow afternoon into Sunday evening. It starts to approach northeastern New Zealand. At this point, it may be extra tropical. Obviously, you don't have, it doesn't look likely to have another landfall, but obviously a powerful system for that area.
So we'll keep an eye on it. Not active here.
Right, not yet. Not yet.
All right, thanks, Maria. Well, hey, rainy mess today across much of the Northeast, melting some of those huge snow piles in Boston. But when the rain moves out, the cold air moves in. We're going to show you when the freezing temperatures will return.
And from calculations to cooking, parents, it's time to put Pi Day to good use. I did. I'll show you how this morning in this morning's edition of Momorology.
Are you still getting heartburn flare-ups? Time for a new routine. Try Nexium 24 Hour, the latest choice for frequent heartburn. And get Nexium level protection.
Boston Market introduces our 2 for $20 complete meal deal. For just $20, get two individual meals, like our all-natural rotisserie chicken, two classic sides, two drinks, and two desserts, all for a limited time, only at Boston Market.
With Crizal No Glare lenses, neither scratch, nor smudge, nor glare of night can keep you from the clearest vision possible. Plus, Crizal gives you the most comprehensive UV protection. Crizal No Glare lenses. Live life in the clear.
Toenail fungus? Don't hide it. Tackle it with FDA-approved Jublia. Jublia is a prescription medicine proven to treat toenail fungus. Use Jublia as instructed by your doctor. Once applied, Jublia gets to the site of infection by going under, around, and through the nail. Most common side effects include ingrown toenail, application site redness, itching, swelling, burning or stinging, blisters, and pain. Tackle it. Ask your doctor now if Jublia is right for you.
It's only two of us. How much dirt can we manufacture?
More than you think.
What's that?
What's that?
Swiffer sweeper.
I came in under the assumption that it was clean. I've been living in a fool's paradise.
For 4 days only at Men's Warehouse, great savings just got even better. Right now, buy one, get one free on almost everything in the store. Plus, take an additional 30% off all clearance items, from suits to dress shirts and more. Confidence in every look. Only at Men's Warehouse.
Introducing new Flonase Allergy Relief Nasal Spray. Now available over-the-counter in full prescription strength. When we breathe in allergens, our bodies react by overproducing 6 key inflammatory substances that cause our symptoms. The leading allergy pill only controls 1. Flonase controls 6. And 6 is greater than 1. Flonase, the 24-hour relief that outperforms the number 1 allergy pill. So go ahead, inhale life. New Flonase. 6 is greater than 1. This changes everything.
Sometimes, bigger is better. But other times, bigger just gets in the way. At Brother, we know the biggest printer isn't always the best fit for every office. So we've come up with a bigger idea. Don't supersize, optimize. See how we can help you put the right printers in all the right places and help reduce your costs. Now that's big. Brother, at your side. Learn more at don'tsupersizeoptimize.com.
Transport
Andrew. Rita. Sandy. Meet Chris. Jackie. Joe. Minor damage or major disaster. When you need us most, we're there. State Farm. We're a force of nature, too.
Currently in our area, 83 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, a mix of clouds and sun. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 83. Tonight, mainly clear. Low 70. Winds south-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 87. Chance of rain 40%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Hey, it is now 40 minutes past the hour. Welcome back to Weekend Recharge. And somewhere under the clouds and fog and rain is New York City, sitting at 45 degrees right now. Definitely a rainy start to your final weekend of winter. Woohoo! But hey, at least it's not snowy, wintry right now, right? Or will it be? An evil forecast? Well, definitely we're on for a chill as you look at a busying Times Square here. We had a shot a little while ago. Barely anyone out there, but lots of umbrellas popping up there across the Times Square region. Chill is definitely in the air and coming back to us, despite the fact that it's going to be comfortable this weekend. Borderline warm. In fact, you might even see some 60 before the weekend is out. 56 for a high on Monday. And then just when you think spring is here, oh no, we drop down to 37 for a high. And then we finish the week in the 40s. Spring starts on Friday, 43 for a high. Average is 49. And then back to average as we head on towards next weekend. And this is the reason why. Our jet stream steers around storms, but also separates different air masses. South of it, the warmer air, cold of it, north of it, the cold air. And as our jet stream kind of dips across the region, we're going to allow that cold air from Canada to spill back across the Northeast and New England and even portions of the Mid-Atlantic. That's going to bring us back into the depths of winter cold. Not teens or single digits for highs, no, but definitely some 20s and 30s. We start in the 40s and 50s as we head throughout the week, though. Look at the cold air sink in, and by Tuesday and Wednesday should be the coldest, hopefully the last cold spell of the year. Maria?
Crossing our fingers, Paul, crossing our fingers. Well, it is Pi Day, 3.1415, March 14th, 2015. What could make learning more fun than with food? Go back to my house for Momorology.
There is a really fun connection between pizza and Pi Day. We'll get to that in a second, but it's just another way to celebrate Pi Day and what Pi means with your family, and that's exactly what I want to do with my kids today. We've got Justin, who's 6, Tyler's 4, Michael is 9, and we're going to make pie, pizza pie. So first things first, we need the dough. In this case, I cheated a little bit. We have pre-made crusts here, and of course, all the standard ingredients. Michael, you can go ahead and put the sauce on. We've got cheese, and then any toppings you want that'll make the symbol pie. We picked pepperoni, but I'm thinking, guys, maybe I should have done broccoli, right?
Oh, I love this sauce.
Now that we made the pie, it's time to clean up and get those in the oven. Let's do it. Let's clean this up. Get this in the oven, and we've got one cooking already, guys. Can you smell it? Oh my gosh, it smells so good. Look at this, pizza pie. Look, you can see the pie right there in the pizza with the pepperoni.
Yeah,
how cool is that?
Yeah, look, like right here. It smells good too.
It does smell good.
And it's all fresh.
All right, you guys ready for the pizza pie connection?
Yeah.
You ready? We're gonna calculate the volume of our pizza. And the way you get the volume of a cylinder, which is basically our pizza, is you take pi, right, the number, 3.14, zz, which is twice the radius, and then a is the depth. How thick is our pizza? Pizza equals volume. What pie day would be complete without actual pie? You guys ready for some pie?
Yep. Yeah.
Okay. See, you gotta inspire your kids somehow, right? They're, you know, you've got kids in school. It's STEM. It's emphasis on science, technology, engineering, and math. So
put some
you gotta
fun do in there.
You gotta put
like
some
a pie
fun.
In the face with some math.
Pie in the face. That's how I did it. And we've got some pie here. A wonderful bakery made it in our show colors.
Yeah, this is from Henry's Bakery in Buckhead here in Atlanta. And I gotta say, can this last for 3 weeks? Because I gave up sugar for Lent, and this is torture. You're killing me.
See,
here.
That's why I'm your partner. Your co-anchor. I'll take care of it for you.
No. You just told me. I asked you, Maria, did you bring the pizza in?
I said, no, we ate it. Yeah.
She knew. I can't have sugar.
I'm so sorry.
I'm like, oh, the pizza.
Next year's pie day. I'm all about it.
Right now.
Oh, no, you're not.
Hey, sports, though, also a big part of our show, Weekend Recharge, coming up tomorrow. I'm going to take you to spring training in Fort Myers, Florida, where just a few weeks ago, the Red Sox escaped their winter torture of all that snow. Remember all the snow there? Yeah, well, they took up their baseballs and bats and socks and bubble gum and headed south. Now the players are getting ready for the season and only looking forward, hoping that Fenway will be playable on opening day, April 13th.
I've just arrived in Atlanta, and I can't wait to start telling people how switching to Geico could save them hundreds of dollars on car insurance. But first, my luggage. Ah, there it is. Excuse me, sir, I think you've got the wrong bag.
Sorry, they all look alike, you know.
No worries. Well, car's here. I can't save people money chatting at a baggage claim all day.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Can a protein originally found in a jellyfish improve your memory? Our scientists say yes. Researchers have discovered a protein that actually supports healthier brain function. It's the breakthrough in a supplement called Prevagen. As we age, we lose proteins that support our brain. Prevagen supplements these proteins and has been clinically shown to improve memory. It's safe and effective. For support of healthier brain function, a sharper mind, and clearer thinking, try Prevagen for yourself today.
It took James Dyson 5,000 prototypes to invent the bagless vacuum, and another 10,000 to invent the only vacuum that doesn't lose suction, thanks to patented sonic tips. Everything else is history. Search Kinetic now.
We're here today asking kids what their favorite vegetable is.
Kids?
Now we're going to give those same kids Bush's Baked Beans. And finally, we're going to tell them that Bush's Baked Beans are actually a vegetable.
X-nay on the vegetable bay.
Oh, right. Bush's secret family recipe gives them a delicious flavor, so they're a vegetable that kids actually like.
Bush's Baked Beans, the vegetable that kids love.
This March,
one man's trash.
If you're not happy with how your allergy medicine treats your congestion, rethink relief with Nasacort Allergy 24-Hour. Unlike antihistamines that target only one cause of your symptoms, Nasacort stops more, relieving the worst nasal allergy symptoms, even congestion, for 24 hours. It's non-addictive and has no harsh taste, and unlike Flonase, it's scent and alcohol-free. And it's available over-the-counter at full prescription strength. Rethink your relief with Nasacort. It stops more of what makes you miserable.
Mom and Dad told us they had just made their funeral and burial prearrangements. We thought they already had taken care of that. When we learned it was through Beth Israel and Eternal Light, we knew everything would be handled in the most caring and professional way. We realized it would be one of the most difficult days of our lives. It inspired my husband and me to make our own prearrangements so the burden wouldn't fall on our children when that day comes. It's not an easy thing to think about, but I'm so glad we did.
The call and consultation are free.
Call 1-800-307-9899.
today. A mix of clouds and sun. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 83. Winds southeast at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Tonight, mainly clear, low 70. Winds south-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon, high 87. Chance of rain, 40%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Well, word now of a crowded ferry capsizing in the southeastern Asian country of Myanmar after being slammed by huge waves. At least 21 people are dead, and the government says rescuers pulled 167 people from the sea and brought them to safety. Search and rescue crews are still looking for dozens of people still reported missing. Well, here's Maria with your winter weather update.
All right, Paul, and it is still technically the last weekend of winter, and I thought it'd be great to start off with a beautiful picture. I always love seeing these high-resolution pictures of the Great Lakes in the wintertime because you get to see the snow cover. That's evident, but you also see the ice on the lakes, and you've got some lakes seeing more ice than others. Of course, Lake Ontario on the lower end, 43%, but Lake Erie is still almost all ice. Lake Huron, even Lake Superior at just about 85% ice coverage on average across the Great Lakes. You're about 74%. But on one of those lakes, mostly covered in ice, you have Bayfield, Wisconsin, along the shores of Lake Superior. And I would love checking in on this camera, too. You still see plenty of ice. So it is still that time of year where you've got that going on. But how about the wintry part of that weather story? Definitely for this weekend, there will be spots. So let's kind of talk about that. Earlier, we had some areas that were concerned about some freezing rain. Those advisories have been dropped, but just be careful out on the roads. Winter storm watches in the lighter blue, the storm warnings in the dark blue. And you see where kind of the focus is, northern New England, interior Maine, because right now there's just a lot of rain, and we have that cold rain from Scranton, still New York, Hartford, Boston, Providence, but your temperatures are right on that borderline, right, into the low 30s. Well, we have our jet stream. It's going to try and bring in some of that colder air, plenty of moisture to work with. We've seen that already on the radar, and our storm is going to continue to develop here into the weekend inland. So what that's going to spell out over the next 24 hours is we'll still see the rain, mainly on that I-95 corridor. The snow, for the most part, this afternoon, staying well to the north. Now, by tonight, you have the cooling temperatures, but our storm's also winding up. You're going to see that cold air being pulled on down. So we're going to get the winds, as well as a little bit more in the way of snow here as we get in through tomorrow for interior New England and certainly on up and through Maine. Just want to point out, you know, we've been keeping tabs on Boston. 2 inches away from setting their seasonal record for snowfall. We're forecasting about 1 inch right now, so we'll see if that comes to fruition. But definitely gangbuster snow here for the state of Maine. Bangor, you're on that purple line there. That's 8 to 12 inches of snowfall as we get in through the day on Sunday. Pretty incredible. But there you go, Boston. By the numbers, this season so far, just over 105 inches of snow. The record season was back in 1995-96, where you got 107.6 inches of snowfall. So I think you're ready to break the record, but ready for spring too.
Your relationship with your dog is pure. It's innocent. It's work, but it's perfect. You wouldn't trade it for the world. So protect your dog with Trifexis. Trifexis is the monthly beef-flavored tablet that prevents heartworm disease, kills fleas, and prevents infestations, and treats and controls hook, round, and whipworm infections. Treatment with fewer than 3 monthly doses after exposure to mosquitoes may not provide complete heartworm prevention. The most common adverse reactions were vomiting, depression, and itching. Serious adverse reactions have been reported following concurrent extra-label use of ivermectin with spinosad, one of the components of Trifexis. Prior to administration, dogs should be tested for existing heartworm infection. You'll take it all, the good and the bad, because that's what makes your relationship irreplaceable. Protect your dog all year long with the 3-in-1 power of Trifexis, available by prescription only. Talk to your veterinarian about how to protect every second you share together.
I knew instantly that this was Wow.
It's Crest HD. It's amazing.
New Crest HD gives you a 6 times healthier mouth and 6 times whiter teeth in just 1 week.
It gets practically every detail. That's why it's called HD.
Try New Crest Pro Health HD.
Doers. They don't worry if something's possible. They just do it. At Sears Optical, we're committed to bringing them eyewear that works as hard as they do. Right now, buy one pair and get another free. Quality eyewear for doers. Sears Optical.
Need an oil change? Right now at Pep Boys, get 5 quarts of Castrol GTX oil and a Purolator Classic filter for only $22.99. Or let the boys do it for you with a full-service conventional oil change for just $24.99 with coupon. Trust the boys to get you there.
Working on my feet all day gave me pain here
in my lower back.
But now I step on this machine and get my number, which matches my Dr. Scholl's custom fit orthotic inserts. Now I get immediate relief from my foot pain.
My lower back pain.
Find a machine at drscholls.com.
Mother Nature can absolutely change people.
I'm ready to get out of here and create a new track.
This is a tornado emergency.
It was hard to believe weather could do that.
Never seen anything like this in my life.
Seven years ago, a deadly tornado tracked through downtown Atlanta. Remember that?
I do remember that. A lot of stuff going on downtown Atlanta. Mm-hmm. SEC championship basketball game. There was an NBA game. Hawks were playing just maybe a stone's throw away in the Phillips Arena here. But still, this is damage from an EF2 tornado that actually killed one person and injured 30 others as it tracked right across the CNN Omni Hotel complex and even right over Phillips Arena as well.
Yeah, as you mentioned, the NBA basketball game was underway and the arena was packed with thousands of fans at the time, and the tornado caused $25 million in damages, like the windows at the Westin, right? They were all shattered.
Also, I guess the Tabernacle, a great venue for performances, also damaged as well. And again, the SEC Championship game, that game went to overtime, right, keeping thousands of people inside the Georgia Dome and not out on the streets of Atlanta as that twister went on through. So the damages, the injuries, it could have been a lot greater.
A lot worse. Yeah, amazing. 7 years ago, incredible. But we want to end this hour with Wonder of Weather. This is kind of a way for you to kind of take in that it's amazing out there mantra that we love here at the Weather Channel. Show you the beautiful, amazing side of weather and from pictures of that you guys send us, which we love. This is a cruising altitude somewhere between Birmingham and Charlotte. Always a great view.
Yeah, on Twitter, it's sent to us from Cheer for Tide there, and they sent that in. Another picture of a little frozen fog and almost like hoarfrost there.
Right.
See those crystals kind of grow. It's a great phenomenon there, but also a sign that, yes, we're still in winter.
And this I love too. This is through our Weather Channel app, and you look up at the location and you get the current conditions, and of course, it's amazing out there and a fantastic picture. So thank you for tweeting that out.
Yeah, you got to tag that on the picture with mm-hmm. all the current stuff. And hey, you know what, spring breakers, barely see this.
That's
sunrise in Jacksonville, but a gorgeous view there on the east side of Florida.
And talk about gorgeous view. What a picture from the Grand Canyon National Parks, and you see the Milky Way as well.
And it's cool. You can take those pictures if you leave your exposure setting on to sit there for a while. Mm-hmm. The quick snap, you're not going to see it. You got to let it sit there. I don't know how long, but I've never done that, but I've been told that.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for joining us on our first Weekend Recharge show. We'll be back tomorrow. And remember, we asked you to kind of set the phones aside for a little bit, but tweet us pictures.
Unplug and recharge.
There you go.
It's amazing out there and in here, too.
Currently in our area, 83 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, a mix of clouds and sun. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 83. Tonight, mainly clear. Low 70. Winds south-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 87. Chance of rain 40%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Hope you're having a great day. I'm meteorologist Maria LaRosa. A few of the big stories that we're following here at the Weather Channel, the flooding that continues in parts of the Ohio River Valley, including in and around Cincinnati, expected to crest as we get in through the next few days here, the highest crest they've seen since the flood of March of 1997. So really dire situation there. So that'll continue. The rain part of it is easing. So that is some good news there. The rain continues pretty steadily, cold rain at that, with temperatures in the 40s from New York into Providence and Boston. Eventually Boston, that is going to be some snow for you as we get through late tonight and tomorrow. But otherwise, some scattered showers here through Nashville. Heads up through the Carolinas, South Carolina, North Carolina, especially the eastern side. There may be some of the stronger thunderstorms with some gusty winds. We'll keep an eye on that as we get in through the later part of tonight. Otherwise, there too, just a few scattered showers as we head into the evening. The upper Midwest looking dry, including from Chicago into Minneapolis.
In a blinding snowstorm, a plane can't gain altitude.
The runway felt like an old mud road with potholes that were 2 feet deep, with ba-boom, ba-boom, ba-boom all the way down the runway.
It slams into a bridge and plunges nose first into frigid waters. On a foggy night, a commuter plane, much too low, crashes in the woods. Only one person survives.
I wasn't in one plane crash. It seems like I was in 10,000 plane crashes because I've had 10,000 nightmares.
Then, a trip for some friends turns tragic when a fire breaks out in flight and an emergency landing goes horribly wrong.
We were up in the air for 1 hour and enjoying our time together. It went from that to sudden terror.
I think it was a very grim situation inside that airplane.
Deadly plane crashes from the few who survive, with dramatic animations that put you up close and inside the troubled cabin. These are the last words from the cockpit of Air Florida Flight 90. The sound of impact is the Tampa-bound Boeing 737 slamming into the 14th Street Bridge in Washington, D.C., and plunging into the icy Potomac River.
It was just before 4, the bridge heavily loaded with commuter traffic, people trying to get home early in a snowstorm.
There is a hole in the ice that looked like someone had taken a baseball and thrown it through a plate glass window. I remember just thinking in amazement, oh my goodness, the plane is underwater with all those people.
Chester Panzer is a cameraman for a Washington TV station. Even before this plane crash, January 13th, 1982 is a busy news day.
We're calling for 5 to 10 inches of snow for the mid-Atlantic states throughout the northeastern states today.
I met my sound man, George Patterson, and we were sent to National Airport, which was closed because of the snow. And all the local TV stations are at the airport doing the same story, talking to people that are stranded. So we shot a story, and the assignment desk told George and I, are you guys done for the day? We were sitting in traffic about a half hour, 40 minutes, and the assignment desk came on our two-way radio, and they said, we heard something about a small plane crash at National Airport. We want you guys to check it out. George turned on WTOP, the all-news radio station.
I'm Pam Coulter, here along with WTOP Steve Thompson.
What we do know is that an Air Florida 737 jet has crashed into the Potomac River.
Panzer and his sound man make a U-turn and slip and slide their way back toward the 14th Street Bridge, which has two spans, one heading south from D.C. into Virginia, the other heading north from Virginia into D.C. By the time the crew gets there and unloads their gear, a United States Park Police rescue chopper, Eagle One, is already on the scene. It's been about 20 minutes since the plane crashed. Panzer quickly aims his camera at the water and catches the rescue of flight attendant Kelly Duncan.
Her dress is all ripped and her stockings, and she's hanging on for dear life.